Recording is a huge part of the song creation process, and today I want to share with you the one tool that helps me do it faster and more efficiently, my recording template. So last year I shared with you guys my production template, which was geared towards music creation, but as we know, that is not where the music stops. Aside from the musical composition, we sometimes also have vocals, and we need an effective way to not only capture, but also mix them in with everything else. Over the past couple of months, I have been working on a new template to help you guys do just that, and today I'm happy to announce that it is finally available. The template is called the Engineer's Template, and you can pick it up by clicking the first link down below, or by heading over to theengineerstemplate.com, but in this video, I want to give you guys a little overview as to what you can expect. Okay, so this here is the Engineer's Template, and there are basically two parts to this, the timeline and the mixer. Starting with the timeline here, you will see all of the tracks that I have pre-built and arranged for you to accommodate several vocal arrangements and genres. I'm going to explain how each of these tracks work in a little bit, but let's do a quick overview. If we take a look, you can see that we have a beat track, a record track, and then a folder track titled Vox, which if we open, further displays more folder tracks for different vocal categories such as lead vocals, unison vocals or doubles, harmonies, ad-libs, and then vocal effects such as delay throws. Finally, if we open up these folder tracks, you will get presented with the actual vocal tracks where the recorded audio will ultimately end up. And here we have common ones such as verses, pre-choruses, choruses, unison center vocals, unison left and right vocals, which are already pre-panned for you, and so much more. Now, the tracks in the template have been pre-added in a way that accommodates several genres, and it's really easy to adjust them to fit your needs. So for example, if you're recording a pop or R&B track, then you might want to keep all of these tracks so that you can record some harmonies or doubles. On the other hand, you might find yourself recording rap vocals, which don't usually tend to have that many stacks, so you might find that you don't need the harmonies. If that is the case for you, then simply go over to this little icon here on the top left, click on that, go down to where you see the harmonies folder, click on this little circle, and immediately you can see that the tracks have been hidden. These tracks are simply empty audio and folder tracks that don't take up any processing power, so if you find yourself not needing some, I always recommend that you hide them like we did just now instead of removing them. That way, you don't have to re-add them and their routing if you ever do need them later. Okay, so now that you understand the layout, let's talk about recording techniques. There are a ton of different ways to record your vocals, but my favorite way is to use a designated record track as opposed to recording straight into my vocal track. The reason for this is because I find that it not only gives me more control, but it streamlines the entire process a lot more. And once you use it in combination with the layers feature in Studio One, the workflow, even for comping vocals, becomes super efficient. Let me show you. So let's assume that I am recording somebody, and for our purposes, that somebody will be me. By using one dedicated recording track, the first benefit that I come across is that the mic routing becomes easier for the engineer because they don't have to worry about routing the mic to every track every time. Instead, all you have to worry about is routing the correct mic to one track, the recording track, and you're done. So the basic idea here is that you will record all your vocals into this one recording track and then drag them down into the appropriate vocal track once you're done. Now, often when recording, artists will need several takes to get it right. So what I have done is that I have preloaded each of these vocal tracks with three individual layers where each of the recorded takes will go. I added three by default, but of course you can always add more. But at the end of the day, once you have all the takes that you need, you can easily comp the vocal to create that one final master take. Okay, so let's pretend that I'm recording a verse here for this song. Let me first activate my recording track, which is routed to this mic here, and let's go ahead and do some recording. You look amazing. Cool. Bring it down to take number one. Let's do it again. You look amazing. Awesome. Last time. You look amazing. Okay, so once you have all of your tracks to audition them, all you have to do is press this little solo button here in the layer. So let's see what we got. You look amazing. Okay, I like the second half of this, not so much that first little bit. Take a listen to the second one. You look amazing. Totally opposite for this one. I like the little first bit, not the second. And the third. You look amazing. I mean, it's okay. So what I'm going to do then is unsolo this so we can hear the main take now. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the first bit of this second take and that last whole bit of the first take. So now we can close this out and we have our final take. You look amazing. Awesome. Okay, so now that we've covered the recording process, let's talk really quickly about instrumentation. If you're recording something like rap, it is very common to only receive one single wave or MP3 file. That's not ideal, but it happens, so if that's your case, all you have to do is drop that file into this beat track, and you're done. Since it's the only track, all of your processing for the beat, if at all, will be on that single beat track itself. Now, if you're lucky enough to receive the beat multi-tracks, then the template also has you covered, and this is where we start to see more of its versatility because it's not just a recording template, but also a mixing template that is fully pre-routed for you. So then if you want to bring in beat multi-tracks, simply go over once again to that top left icon from before, open that up, and then go all the way to the bottom until you see three empty folder tracks called Melodies, Drums, and Effects, and go ahead and unhide those. Now, immediately, you will see those empty folder tracks appear here on the timeline, and if you already own my production template, then this should be very familiar to you. Once here, simply take the beat multi-tracks, and here you can either pre-scout them wherever you have them, and then drag them into their appropriate folders, which, of course, you can always just rename yourself, or you can just highlight them all, bring them in here to the bottom in Studio One, and once here, you can simply go ahead and just drag them to their appropriate folders. In any case, that was the timeline, but now let's talk about the mixer because this is where it starts to get fun. Now, upon opening up the mixer, you can see that I have gone ahead and also pre-routed everything for you with the main theme behind every decision being control. My goal with this template was to give you the most control possible when it came to recording and mixing so that you can be as creative as you want to be. When it comes to mixing, I love using buses, VCA faders, and send effects, and all of those elements have been incorporated into this template. Now, if you're unfamiliar, a bus in Studio One is simply a channel where you send multiple sources so that you can affect them all at once and save processing power. A VCA, on the other hand, is a single channel fader that is able to control the volume of multiple other channels at once. So then if we take a look, you can see that we have channels that correspond to the vocal tracks from before, so verses, pre-choruses, and choruses. Now, right after each category of vocals, you will also find a VCA fader and a bus that pertain to those tracks. So for example, this VCA fader here is titled LV faders because it controls all of the volume for the lead vocal tracks, as you can see here. All of these lead vocal tracks have also already been pre-routed to their appropriate bus, which is right over here, so that if you want to add a plugin and affect all of the lead vocals, you can do that easily. Now, some people will take all of the verses, pre-choruses, and choruses and put them all into one track and call that lead vocals, but I personally like to have control over the volume for each. The routing in this template gives me the freedom to do just that while at the same time being able to group them all into one bus so that I can process them together if that's what I choose to do. Now, this logic has been applied to every other vocal track, so it makes it really easy to control and to do whatever you want to do, but I've taken this a step further because, as mentioned, I also included some vocal send effects so that you can send your vocal tracks to if you want to do some parallel processing. Some of the effects included here include vocal widening, a short reverb, a long reverb, and then a quarter and half note delay. Now, all the plugins used for these effects are native Studio One plugins, so you don't have to worry about going to buy something different, something else. You have everything that you need right out of the box. So let me show you how those send effects work. Basically, what I would do is I would go ahead and go over to my bus that I want to affect. So that piece that I recorded is in the verse section, which pertains to the lead vocals. From here, all you have to do is click send. Let's do a little bit of a short reverb.
You look amazing. You look amazing. You look.
Let's add a long reverb as well.
You look amazing. You look amazing.
And then a little bit of vocal widening, why not?
You look amazing.
And there you go. Now, at the very end of this vocal segment here, all of these vocal tracks and sends get routed to one final vocal VCA fader and vocal bus. That way, if you want to affect the volume of all the vocals in the entire mix, then you can do that. And if you want to add a plugin to affect all of the vocals, say like a filter, then you can do that as well. Finally, if you notice, there is also a song VCA and a song bus, and that is because these control the entire song, including the beat file or beat track outs. Now, speaking of beat multitracks, if you do have them available and you want to work with them, then after you unhide the folders from the timeline and then you route all of your tracks to where they need to go, the next thing you want to do is you want to open up this channel list icon here. And then in the mixer, you also want to unhide the send effects, the buses, and then the VCA faders for the beat. Now, much like with the other channels, the beat VCA here will allow you to control the volume of the beat as a whole, while the beat bus will allow you to drop plugins that will only affect the beat. I've also gone ahead and included here some send effects for the beat multitracks in case you want to use them. Admittedly, for beat effects, I often prefer to use inserts over sends, but I will occasionally use a reverb send on my drums, for example, to make them all sound more cohesive. Now, if you are going to import some beat multitracks, the very last step here would be to basically route all of them to their appropriate VCA faders and buses. Now, to do that, it's super simple. All you have to do is first select a couple of tracks. So I'm going to do the melodies first. So I'm going to select them all here. And then down where you see main, instead of sending them out to the main bus, you send them out to the melodies bus. And at the bottom, in this little kind of rectangle near the bottom here, you want to send that over to the melodies faders. And you do the same thing for the drums, which for me here are green. Instead of main, we're going out to the drums bus, and down here at the bottom, going to drum faders. Okay, but that was the engineer's template. It is an easy and effective way to not only capture vocals, but also mix your songs in Studio One. The template is fully customizable, and even though I spoke about the majority of it in this video, there are more instructional videos inside of the product portal after you purchase that basically walk you through how to install it and how to customize it. Finally, as with all of my other products, if you purchase, you also get lifetime updates. But there you have it. Go pick up the engineer's template from the description down below. And if you're already a production template owner, then go ahead and download this latest version as well. As always, thank you so much for your time. Go make some great music, and I'll see you on the next one.